Welcome back to The Spirit's Educator. My name is Brian Donnelly. On this channel, I provide in-depth spirits information, brand transparency, and category education for bartenders, distributors, and enthusiasts. If you are new here, please give this video a like and consider subscribing for more brand trainings just like this one. Dan Garrison was the vice president of marketing for a software company in Austin, Texas, before he created a bourbon brand. When his most prominent client, Enron, went bankrupt due to accounting fraud, his company also went bankrupt, and Dan, along with 12,000 other Texans, lost his job. At the age of 40, Dan Garrison needed to figure out what he was going to do next to support his family. Dan was a lifelong bourbon drinker, and his wife told him, with as much bourbon as he drinks, he might as well make the stuff. This came after Dan was poking fun at her because she drank vodka, which he viewed as being tasteless and bland. According to Dan, all great ideas come from wives who don't know what they're getting themselves into. Needing to reinvent himself, Dan took this remark as permission from his wife and headed to Kentucky in 2003. While in bourbon country, Dan visited 9 distilleries and was blown away by the selection available. Before visiting Kentucky, Dan was introduced to a woman nicknamed Mac, who is the former director of marketing for Buffalo Trace and had recently relocated from Kentucky to Dan's home state of Texas. Mac introduced Dan to a who's who of Kentucky bourbon's royalty, including Max Shapiro of Heaven Hill, Bill Samuels Jr. of Maker's Mark, Craig Beam of Heaven Hill, Harlan Wheatley of Buffalo Trace, Elmer T. Lee of George T. Stagg, now Buffalo Trace, Eddie and Jimmy Russell of Wild Turkey, and Dave Pickerell, formerly of Maker's Mark. Dan just took notes, learned, and finally wrote up a business plan for what would become Garrison Brothers Bourbon. Dan borrowed money from his dad, brother, and wife to start the brand. First, he had to overcome several legal challenges to ensure that he could produce bourbon in the state of Texas. Texas at the time did not view the liquor industry as a growth industry. The distillery received its federal permit in 2007 and the state permit in 2008. Since Dan didn't have any money and had yet to sell a bottle of bourbon, his first employee was a retired local carpenter named Fred Cook that helped him build the buildings at the distillery. Next, the current master distiller, Donis Todd, arrived and pitched Dan on hiring him, even though the brand's financing was minimal. Now Donis runs the entire facility and knows how to fix everything from the plumbing to the electrical lines. Dan says that Donis is the best distiller in the whole country, and without him, the brand would have never survived. In addition to distilling, Donis also understands every aspect of aging in the unique climate of High Texas. There is a fantastic write-up about Donis in Esquire magazine that I'll link below. Using a 100-gallon Vendome copper pot still that Dan had purchased from Elmer T. Lee, the former master distiller at George T. Stagg, now Buffalo Trace, Dan and his first employee worked 24 hours a day in 8-hour shifts for the first 3 years to reach the point where they could sell their bourbon. Dan also received a lot of help from his friend and former Whistlepig master distiller, Dave Pickerell, who unfortunately passed away in November of 2018. After a lot of trial and error and overcoming many challenges, Garrison Brothers sold their first bottle of bourbon on Texas Independence Day, March 2nd, 2010. The first release was a 1-year-old bourbon called Young Gun, sold in a 375-milliliter bottle that Dan purchased at a discount from a glass plant. At the time, he didn't have enough money for a custom bottle. The distillery didn't have any employees to bottle all the bourbon they were making. So Dan recruited neighbors and friends from nearby Stonewall, Texas, to to help with the bottling. He paid them in free barbecue, beer, and of course bourbon. Now, there is a long wait of volunteers who want to help dip the top of the bottles in wax. In addition to bourbon, the brand also has a 501c3 charitable organization called Good Bourbon for a Good Cause that has raised over $1 million for important causes such as veterans with PTSD, healthcare for hospitality workers, Texas state parks, and COVID-19 relief. Dan truly believes that good bourbon can change the world. The mash bill for Garrison Brothers bourbon is 74% corn, 15% red winter wheat, and 11% malted barley. The corn is food grade number one white corn sourced from a farm in South Texas with a larger kernel which will produce much more starch and sugar. The non-GMO red winter wheat has been grown by Dan on his 90-acre farm. The brand sources some barley from Texas, but most of the barley comes from colder climates in the northern parts of the United States. The water source for all aspects of the production process is filtered rainwater. Each building on the property is equipped with rain catchers. Garrison Brothers uses a sweet mash fermentation method, which is very different than the big distilleries in Kentucky. This means that the distillery does not use a sour mash or backset technique during fermentation. The sour mash technique adds backset, or the highly acidic residue that comes out of the base of the beer still after distillation, to the next round of fermentation. This acidic residue maintains the pH levels during fermentation and provides consistency and adds flavor. This practice is the standard for the big bourbon distilleries in Kentucky. Fermentation at Garrison Brothers takes 4 days to complete and produces a worth of 22% ABV, which is exceptionally high compared to other producers. The higher alcohol comes from the larger grains, which will have much more starch to convert into alcohol. The production runs 24/7 and 365 at the distillery, and it only takes 4 days to go from grain to barrel. The first still at the distillery was a small 100-gallon Vendome pilot still that Dan Garrison purchased from Elmer T. Lee, the former master distiller at the George T. Stagg Distillery, now Buffalo Trace. Supposedly, this was the pilot still that Elmer T. Lee used to develop Blanton's, which was the first commercially available single barrel bourbon. The distillery now has 4 different copper pot stills made by the world famous Vendome Copper and Brass in Louisville, Kentucky. The newest and main still is a 2,000 gallon, 16 foot high copper pot still with 8 rectification plates nicknamed Big Johnson. The other two stills are 500 gallon copper pot stills nicknamed Fat Man and Little Boy. In keeping with their tradition of doing things differently than the big boys in Kentucky, the Garrison Brothers Distillery does not use a thumper. It completes their distillation in a single run. Dan and Donis feel that this creates a bourbon with more texture and body. Finally, the distillery does not filter the wort before distillation, and the proof off the still is between 125 and 138 proof. The aging or maturation process is one area of production that truly separates Garrison Brothers from other bourbon brands, especially those made in Kentucky. The distillery is located in High Texas, which is about an hour and a half west of Austin by car. This part of Texas has much more intense temperature swings than Kentucky. The climate here is scorching, with temperatures that can reach 115 degrees Fahrenheit in the summer and 40 degrees Fahrenheit in the winter. These temperature extremes put an enormous strain and pressure on the aging barrels. In the beginning, Dan Garrison purchased his first barrels from Kelvin Cooperage. These were smaller barrels with a 3-minute toast and a number 4 char. He filled these barrels completely full of new make spirit or white dog, not wanting to waste any space in the barrel. At the time, the distillery didn't have their own aging facilities, so Dan kept the barrels in used shipping containers, which only increased the heat. 18 of these barrels popped in the first summer, which meant that the staves cracked from the heat and the pressure and spilled the aging spirit everywhere. Dan sampled what little product was left and realized he was really onto something if he could just figure out what types of barrels would work in that climate. He continued to use smaller 15 and 30 gallon barrels and worked with the cooperage to create thicker staves, which are about 1 1/4 inch thick. In addition to thicker staves, Dan also leaves more head space in the barrel, only filling each barrel about 90 to 95% full. This will allow more room for the bourbon to expand and minimize the pressure on the wood. The brand continues to purchase barrels from Kelvin Cooperage in Louisville, Kentucky, made from American oak sourced from the Ozarks, and Barrel Mill in Avon, Minnesota, which are made from American oak sourced from Minnesota. Both kinds of wood are seasoned 36 months before being used to make barrels. These barrels receive a 3-minute toast, then a 53-second char. Master distiller Donis Todd uses multiple barrel entry proofs depending on the cooperage, product, and barrel size. The general range is between 111 and 124 proof. There are 5 one-story aging barns on the property. The brand still uses transatlantic shipping containers to create microclimates and different aging environments. The shipping containers are 40 feet by 8 feet and each can fit 36 barrels. The angel share or evaporation rate is between 13 and 15%. To put that into perspective, the angel share in Kentucky is between 5 and 7% and in Scotland it's only between 2 and 3%. All expressions of Garrison Brothers have been aged a minimum of 4 years and are non-chill filtered. The small batch expression with a black wax top is the brand's flagship product. All Garrison Brothers bourbon uses the same mash bill and production method, with the only differences coming with different aging techniques and cast finishings. All the line extensions in the family of brands start with the small batch. The small batch is a mingling of 55 barrels aged a minimum of 4 years that will deliver the same target flavor profile to consumers bottle after bottle. This expression is bottled at 94 proof or 47% ABV. The Honeydew expression has a yellow wax top. This expression originated from a special request from Dan's wife. She wanted him to make something like a liqueur or a cordial, but Dan was adamant that he was only going to make bourbon. The single barrel expression has a gray wax top. Donis chooses these barrels because they are unique and more interesting and offer a different flavor profile outside of those barrels used for the small batch expression. Donis is looking for barrels with more character. This expression is bottled at either barrel proof or 94 proof or 47% ABV. The brand packs their 6-pack cases of this expression with 6 different bottles from 6 different barrels. This sampler pack ensures that customers will always have something new because no single barrel are the same. The Balmoray expression has a blue wax top and is a double oaked bourbon named after the Texas State Park located between Austin and El Paso. Dan jokes that this product was created just to piss off their accountants. This product starts off as a 4-year-old bourbon which has been aged in new American white oak barrels made from Ozark wood. Then cast finish for an additional 2 years in a second new American white oak barrel made from Minnesota wood. The liquid is extremely dark with no added color, and the flavor can only be described as bourbon candy. This expression is bottled at 115 proof or 57.5% ABV. Through their in-house charitable organization, Good Bourbon for a Good Cause, The brand donates money from the selling of this product to the Texas Parks and Wildlife to aid in the rebuilding of Balmoray State Park. The Guadalupe Expression has a dark orange wax top. This Expression is their four-year-old bourbon that has been cask finished for 2 years in tawny port casks. Master distiller Donis Todd selected 90 30-gallon bourbon barrels that had been initially filled in 2015. The Angel's share losses were about 13 gallons per barrel, meaning that there was just 1,530 gallons of bourbon to be used. This liquid would enter into 26 59-gallon port casks in 2019. This Expression is bottled at 107 proof or 53.3% ABV. The Cowboy Expression has a gold wax top and is the annual limited time offering release from the brand. The barrels used for Cowboy are hand selected by master distiller Donis Todd and are bottled at cask strength, uncut and unfiltered. The 2021 release was distilled and barreled in 2014, aged a minimum of 7 years, and bottled at 131.3 proof or 65.65% ABV. Please note that you will need to visit the Garrison Brothers website for more information about the Laguna Madre or High Rye Expressions. I did not include them because at this time they are distillery exclusive items. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, please drink responsibly.